Right. Thank you for coming.
It's so nice to see everybody else. I know, it's so
So I was trying to think like what I should talk about, right? And I don't really know what to talk about, but I just finished Portland Open Studios Artists this year, and one of the things that they're doing on the Facebook page is doing these profiles of other artists. And so I was just answering some of the questions for this profile, and I was like, oh, that'd be a good thing to talk about. So what I was going to just talk about a little bit was sort of my process and my inspirations and sort of really important events as an artist that sort of like pivotal events. So those are some of the questions. So if you're on Facebook, you should go to Portland Open Studios page and like it, and they're going to focus on all of the artists, each one, 104. So what I wanted to say was that I am pretty much, very much a self-taught artist. I've taken a few classes. I took a couple of figure drawing classes, and I took from Phil Sylvester, some people might know. And the thing that I really learned from Phil was to draw things as you see them, so that if you see somebody's foot looks really big, like make it big, you know, whatever. So that shows up in my paintings a lot. Like I just feel like if I see a big hand in my painting, I just put the big hand in. Or if I see like the head is going like this way, but the body's kind of going that way, I just make it look like that, and I don't worry about it. The second class that I took when I started painting was from Serena Barton, and she taught me that you could paint with your hands and with paper towels. And I didn't know that. I thought painters had to paint with brushes, and they had to, you know, paint a certain way. So that adds just a lot of freedom to my paintings. And then I took classes from Jesse Reno, and what I learned from him was that when something isn't moving your painting forward, to just get rid of it and to let things just change and not get stuck on like one thing, like this must be a dog because I want it to be a dog, or maybe it's going to end up being like a girl swimming in the ocean at the end. I don't know. So letting things go like that. So that was the one thing I wanted to talk about, because I always thought that I really wanted to be an artist, a painter forever, and I thought that I couldn't do it because I didn't go to art school, I didn't have any formal training, and I didn't know how to paint, and you have to, you know, there were all these secrets. And as I started to paint, I realized, well, I really am learning to paint. Just every time I make a painting, I'm learning like what paint does and how to change it, how to move it, what people look like, what their bodies look like, how to change. Just all that stuff, kind of every day is a lesson. Secondly, when we had our opening, this man asked me what my inspiration was for my painting. And I was like, oh, that's a really good question, and I didn't really have a very good answer. And I started, like, thinking more, because I think artists always think about, like, why we paint, you know, why we paint. And I really paint because it's really fun. It really is true. I just really like paint. I like watching it on paper. I like seeing things appear. I just like the process. I think it's really magical to like have this blank board, and then at the end you have this thing that's never been seen before. I think that's magic, you know. So my process is that I start with sort of an intention. I sort of talk to the board, and I just write things on the board, like, you know, let's make something really awesome, or let's make a painting about taking a step, or like all of these. And then I just put layers of color and lines, and I just work it, lots and lots and lots of layers. And at some point, I start to see, oh, look, that looks like it could be a head. That looks like it's a head. And then I start thinking about how that, whatever this image is that's starting to appear, matches the intention that I brought to the paintings. So with these paintings, I wanted to come up with things that talked about taking a step. And so I would say, okay, how does that, you know, what does that have to do with that story, that intention? And then I'll start just finding imagery, and I paint in the negative space, and then start looking for other things that sort of tell that story. And I never really know what it's going to be. It's just, it's really fun, and it's like I said, I think it's magic. I'm also really inspired by just what it's like to be a human in relationship with other humans, and just all of the ways we relate, and not just as humans, but just all beings, animals, and strange beings that, you know, I don't even know who they are, but they show up in my paintings. So there's that. And then I was thinking about experiences as an artist that have been really important to me in developing as a painter. And one of them was when I was featured on Oregon Art Beat. It really gave me this sense of, oh, I must be a real artist because they want to talk about my art. And because it was, it gave me access to so many people that who never would have been able to see my art. And a lot of people signed up for my workshops. At that time, I was teaching workshops. And I just got to meet, like, I met so many people just from those workshops that I'd never have met. And that's been a really awesome part of it. And then the second thing that I was thinking about was meeting Fred Swan. So if people know Fred Swan, he's just like the most gracious, creative, lovely person ever. And kind of falling into his orbit just really gives me this really lovely feeling of grace and gratitude. And so that's been a really important part of being with that artist community. And then, I guess that's that. So right now what I'm doing with my painting, if you like are familiar with my art at all, before this series of paintings, my paintings were like really bright. I love color, and I was really like used really bright color. And I kind of just kept trying to push it to see like how bright and colorful can a painting be before it gets like garish. And I kind of hit garish in the fall with this painting, and I was like, whoa, okay, I went too far. Except then last night I was showing Chuck a picture of it because I painted over it. It's become something else now. It might be that. But I was saying, oh, I shouldn't have painted over this. Why did I do that? I should have been brave enough to keep it, you know. But I didn't. So anyway, last fall I started painting just kind of really kind of blue and gray paintings. And I think in part I was just kind of depressed from the fall and events that were happening, things like that. But then I started really liking the kind of a very simple color palette because it was just kind of soothing, you know, it was just like kind of took things down. And so I made a number of little paintings that were like blues and grays, and people liked them a lot. And then we were going to have a show at the P5 Gallery downtown, which is like dark wood. The walls are made of dark wood. And so I knew I needed to have paintings that were going to be needed to be able to stand out with the dark wood. And so I started this series of paintings that had white backgrounds or light backgrounds. But I knew that they had to have, like, I really like contrast in my art. So I knew they had to have, like, something to really make them pop. So I started using a lot of, like, really, like, severe black lines and splotches and things. And so I made four paintings for that show, and then it just sort of continued on into this show, and it was like perfect, right? So now what I'm kind of doing is I'm just sort of using a more subtle color palette, but I'm still trying to figure out how to get a lot of contrast in with the more subtle colors. And the way that I'm generally doing it is with like the black lines, just like that. So that's my formal presentation. That I can answer. Yes.
Yeah, I'm curious about the orange blindfolds that happen here. Is that like at the very end of the painting?
Yeah.
What's that about?
You don't have to.